This is Anirban Ganguly. And this is his rally in Bolpur constituency in Birbhum, where he is contesting on a BJP ticket. Bolpur, a small town with a population of less than 1 lakh people, seems to have missed the development bus. We spoke to the women of the village where the BJP rally was held, and they complained about lack of toilets, basic drainage facility and town planning. But they didn't wish to speak on camera. While there seems to be disappointment towards the TMC, the central government's PM Jan Dhan lockdown scheme seems to have reached almost all households. Ganguly is hoping to win Bolpur on the goodwill of centre's welfare schemes and anti-incumbency sentiments against TMC. We spoke to him about his candidature and BJP ideology. Watch what he has to say.
Welcome to News Laundry Interviews. Today we are with Anirban Ganguly. He's the director of Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Research Foundation, which is a nationalist think tank and affiliated with the BJP. He's also the national co-in-charge of the Library and Documentation Department of the BJP and a member of the Policy Research Department of the party. He's authored and edited books, including one on Amit Shah, and he is contesting the Bolpur seat from Birbhum, which is why we're here to interview him. Welcome. Many of your critics and many of the intellectuals would accuse the BJP of destroying Bengal's culture rather than restoring it.
Yes. You see, I mean, for example, there was this effort to say that even this, even Jai Shri Ram is not a Bengali slogan or, you know, but as I said, in Bengal, you have one of the greatest translators of Ramayana, who made it actually a social, turned it into a social movement. So, in fact, what has happened is that there's this entire subaltern religious sentiment and emotion which was completely suppressed by the left and which was not allowed to find expression even under the TMC till we came into the picture. So, I think it is on the other hand, what Bengal's culture is not certainly is to call others outsiders, that you can't come, you can't do politics in Bengal, you can't speak. I mean, if you can't speak in Bengali, you are an outsider. This was never there in Bengal.
Now, I just wanted you to define for me Bengali Hindutva, because I've heard of this a lot in BJP offices. There is a sense that there is an arrival of Bengali Hindutva and it's here to stay, and is distinct from, say, what Hindutva means in UP or Bihar or the Hindi heartland. What are your views on that?
You see, in Bengal, the Hindutva has a very distinct flavor. Now, historically, if you look at West Bengal, it's very clear that at that time when Shyama Prasad Mukherjee put forward the, you know, the demand, he said that we do not support partition. But if, I mean, this is there in his public statement in March 1947 after the Tarakeshwar Hindu Mahasabha convention. He said that if partition is agreed to between the Congress and the Muslim League and Bengal is given away to Pakistan, then we demand the partition of Bengal. And he clearly enunciated there that we need a piece of land which is our own, Bengali Hindus, where we can continue with our mode of worship, our cultural expression and our way of life and living, and where we form that portion where we are there protected for the future. So the founding idea of West Bengal also in a sense is rooted in its Hindu, Bengali Hindu identity.
So then my follow-up question would be, in present day India, in the BJP and RSS's imagination, is West Bengal a homeland for Hindus?
The founding idea is that it was founded so that the Bengali Hindus could stay, but it was not limited to the Bengali Hindus.
You have a candidate from Hindu Samati who's very, very, his speeches are very, very problematic.
He said, Devtanu, I think. Yeah. No, but why should his speeches be problematic? Because just because he talks of the actual reality on the ground, if you go to Nadia, the districts, not 24 parganas. I mean, sometimes those who have actually gone in pockets, you would really have to ask yourself whether you are in India and whether the constitution applies here. So there is an angst.
In what sense?
The way the Hindu communities, the villages are targeted, the way the women are, targeted. But in a large segment also, especially along the border areas, you are targeted and thrown out because you are a Hindu. And so the gentleman you referred to expresses that angst in his own way.
But so would places where there's majority Hindu would do that to Muslim. Isn't that a problem of majoritarianism, which the BJP should fight on both sides?
No, but that I have not come across majority Hindu villages doing this. I have not come across.
When the BJP distinguishes itself from TMC, saying that, we are a new party, we're going to change things. 30 of your candidates are from TMC. I think around many of them came in 2017, some of the popular ones today. So a lot of your party is basically TMC. So how is it going to be different from BJP? And the TMC guys say that we threw away our corrupt guys and now they've gone to BJP.
They did not throw away till they joined us. They did not throw them away. And then what happens is most of the popular mass leaders in the TMC have left them. If you look around today, there is no mass leader in the TMC except Mamata Banerjee. So anyone with a mass base, at a certain point, this was not the case before the rise of the nephew. It's post the rise of nephew. It's a Bengali Stalin phenomena kind of.
But the guys who've come from TMC can't be ideologically aligned to you. It's just siding with power, right?
When they come,
I mean, they're not like you who've been around, who've spent time researching or who've, really feels for.
Obviously, there are categories, but when they come, they cannot be ideologically aligned. They come, but they become ideologically aligned. In Bengal, with a number of leaders also who have joined us in 2017, this is the same feeling. Some who have just joined us will take some time, but I'm sure they'll integrate because our party structure is an organized party.
We asked a bunch of people here because it's Shanti Niketan what they think of the Prime Minister's beard.